Hi, I'm Jean, and today we are going to be furthering our yogic breathing practice. Now, again, when looking at this from a psychology perspective, breathing is one of the fundamental areas that we can develop. Now, in psychology, we look at something known as the fight, flight, or freeze response, okay? This is what happens when we get into a space of extreme stress. Okay, do we flight and run away? Do we freeze and just kind of stand there? Or do we fight and go towards it and try and navigate these flux of emotions that we're feeling? Okay, now Dr. Daniel Siegal is an incredible American psychiatrist, and he developed the hand model, which is really incredible to be able to explain what happens when we get into stress. Okay, so let's take a look at this. Now, this here, your wrist being the brain stem, your thumb that comes over here, this is all representing the limbic system, okay? And your fingers going over it represents the cortex, okay, which is the frontal higher part of the brain, okay? So now our limbic area controls our emotions and our flight, fight, or freeze response, okay? Our cortex controls how our thinking and our rational way of being in the world, and our logic and how we function, okay? And now what happens, and what's really cool to see this, is that when we are in extreme stressed space, our limbic system is busy pumping. Okay, we are stressed, so it's going, it's very, very stressed. Then all of a sudden, I don't know if you've heard the term, but we flip our lid, okay? What that means is that we lose control. We are so stressed that there is no more logic, there is no more reason, there is no more easy way of functioning. So what do? We flip our lid and we freak out. In this space, there is no point to try and get somebody to think logically. They're stressed. We've all felt that, okay? What do? And what can we do? One of the things that we can do is we can learn to breathe. Bring our awareness to a point of concentration, get us back into that breath, okay? So when that is something that is such an amazing model to teach kids. What happens when they get really stressed? They flip their lids. What happens with adults when they get stressed? They flip their lids. Now, trying to go and write an assignment is pointless. What do? We have to now go and regather our stress, and we have to be able to take control, and breath is an easy way of doing that. So now when we're looking at the yogic breathing, we're going to now look at the second stage of the yogic breathing, being the thoracic breath. So remember, we focused on the abdominal breathing, the balloon up and down, and now the thoracic breathing is quite complicated, and it now, instead of going up and down, it's literally going side to side, and we are literally looking at the side part of our ribs. So we're placing our hands here, and you'll see the lower part of our ribs are going to be expanding like that. So this is the second part of yogic breathing. We're moving up. Let me demo. Okay, cool. Let me get a full frame. Beautiful. Okay, so now we know we went from abdominal breathing, placing our hands there as a point, breathing up and down, going up, breathing down, breathing up. That's abdominal breath, breathing down. Now, when we now place our hands here, we're going to place our hands just by our rib cage here. Now, instead of our hands moving up and down, the fingers are going to separate, breathing in, breathing out. So your breath is no longer coming right down to your abdominal area. It's coming to your rib area here. So we're breathing and you're expanding to the side and breathing in. It's literally coming. So you are literally going out and in. Out. It's all nasal breathing, hey? None of the breath happens with the mouth. So you're going out, breathing in, and breathing out. Breathing in, breathing out. And when we put it together, you literally do your abdominal and then your thoracic. Okay, so those are the two stages. Okay, the second stage, the thoracic breath, is often the most complex breathing to get going and get right. So think about it like this. The first breath, associate that with the balloon, breathing in. expanding. Now, when you're looking at the second breathing, the thoracic breath, you're now looking here. Imagine a ribbon around that balloon. It's now going. So you are focusing here, abdominal coming out. Then you're focusing on your sides of your rib cage are now expanding. So your hands are like this, breathing in. So it's no longer happening here. It's moved a stage up. Okay, so that is the second stage of yogic breath. Okay, so the first one, abdominal, second one, thoracic. Okay, so imagine now you're in a stressed space and you bring your awareness to your breath and you give yourself a point of concentration. You are taking your mind away from the anxiety. You're letting it focus. Okay, abdominal. And now you're looking at thoracic. You can get yourself into a space of calmness really quickly. Okay, so then of course your brain returns to normal and then you can look at the way and logic, and then you can go reasoning. Okay, so with the thoracic breathing, it is complex. Let me know if you're having questions. I'm happy to do a private little Zoom sesh or whatever, and we could chat about it. I could go through it with you. Let me know, and I hope you have a wonderful day.